my name is Chesna Alexander. Welcome to Open Studio. Today in studio we have John Fredericks, who is a writer with FunDza. Welcome, John. Thank you for having the time to be here with us today. Tell us more about John Fredericks, the writer.
I was born in Cape Town, Athlone.
Okay.
And my father was a refuse man. He was a dustman. So my younger years, I was spent on the refuse dump.
Okay.
Scavengers for book to read and anything of value, because I love reading.
Where did that love for reading come from?
My father was illiterate, so he would bring books home for me to read, you know.
Okay, so you were entertaining him through reading, and in so doing, you found your passion and love for reading and writing.
That's right, yes. And when I was in primary school, I always wrote the best composition, and the teacher would always take me around to the other classrooms to read my compositions. But for me, it wasn't like I'm going to be a writer one day or stuff like that. I just like to put words together, you know, and to live out my daily fantasies and stuff like that.
Was it your escape, reading and writing?
It was my escape, because being poor was normal. Everybody was poor, you know, and also I was born in the apartheid years.
Okay.
And so apartheid was also normal, you know. And it opened my mind.
Wow.
And you can go to other countries, you can learn other cultures and stuff like that. And then I realized that apartheid was not normal.
Okay.
You know, and being poor was not normal, you know.
Okay, so we were talking earlier about you escaping from reality through books and things. Did you manage to escape the way the youth that time? I know there was a lot of violence and gangsterism and things like that. Did you manage to escape that part of life at the time, or did you somehow end up doing things that weren't necessarily legal?
I did escape that. But okay. Then something happened.
Okay.
In my life, you know, and people always talk about why youth join gangs.
Yeah.
You know, they've got all these different reasons why youth join gangs. But something happened in my life that was buried in my mind for quite a long time, you know, because I was still young.
Okay.
And I didn't realize what happened to me, you know, but then I sort of unraveled. You know, I became rebellious.
Rebellious, okay.
Yeah, I didn't want to go to school anymore and stuff like that. And as we grew older, you know, we had our own little corner where just hang out, you know.
Okay, it's just standing on the street corners, chatting and things.
And we loved singing, you know.
Okay.
Harmonize and things like that. And other gangs, they wanted soldiers.
Okay.
They want to pull us into the gangs and stuff like that, but we did not want to belong to a gang, you see.
Okay.
And usually they come around there, we're sitting there, maybe we're buying penny polonies, and they come around, they will rob us a polonies, smack us around and things like that.
Oh, wow.
So we decided that it's enough, you know. We decided now we must stand together like a family.
Okay.
And defend ourselves and stuff like that.
Okay, so it seems like unintentionally you guys became a gang without the intention of being one, just to defend yourselves.
That's right. You see, one day we went to watch the film of Cliff Richard, The Young Ones.
Okay.
So when we came out of the cinema,
yeah,
we were like coming down the road singing The Young Ones.
Yeah, yeah, remember the song, yes.
And then the next day somebody wrote on the wall, The Young Ones.
Okay.
So now if something goes wrong in that area, they won't say it's John or somebody else, it will be the young ones.
Okay, and if you were affiliated with any one of them as friends, automatically you're affiliated with
the young ones. So
yeah.
We never started a gang. The people named us as a gang.
It was never your intention, it was just a group of people.
That's right.
This is such an interesting story. We just have to go to a break, and then when we get back, we would be able to, oh, let me just see. We still have a few minutes, actually, so maybe we can finish the story. So you're saying that you guys came together as a group of people, and then the community sort of named you a gang.
Yeah.
Okay.
And, but we were quick, you know, we were, it was rats geweest.
Okay.
You know, and we like to dress, you know.
Dress up and be smart and.
That's right. Because everybody wants to be dressed up.
Yeah.
You know, and so now the gangs, they came for us. They wanted us to belong to them. And that's when the fighting started.
Okay, so you were defending yourself most of the time.
Yeah, and that's when I went to prison for the first time.
Okay.
You know, I was 14 years old. And I got lashes, you know, corporal punishment.
Punishment, yeah.
So now you're 14 years old. You've got the criminal record.
At 14.
Yes, and you are labeled. Then you get the label, you are Skollie.
Okay.
You know?
And then, it's like life happens, what you measure is what you get. When people say something about you, automatically you just become that because that's what everybody is expecting of you.
Yeah.
So you just sort of fall into those things unintentionally. But
you see, when something goes wrong and I'm in the area, it must be me, even if it wasn't me. You know, because I've got the label.
Yeah.
You're the Skollie. So now that time, okay, you call me a Skollie. So now I will show you what the Skollie is about.
Yeah.
You know? So, of course, I become violent and, you know, turn your house upside down and things like that. And all that little petty things. You go to prison. You get arrested. You go to prison and you get lashes.
Oh, wow. And it's so easy, hey? Because it was a matter of circumstances that ended up in jail. And when you came out, people just labeled you as the bad person. And it doesn't matter what you wanted to do going forward, that was the label. But you managed to escape that label because now you're a writer for FunDza. So how did you manage to get out of that?
You know, by the time I was 17 years old, I already had 30 lashes. So that was about 5 cases. So now you're a juvenile, but you're almost a habitual criminal.
Wow. Now we really need to talk a lot more about that, but I see we have to go to a break right now. So please join us after the break to hear more about what happened when he was in jail and how he got away from being labeled a Skollie and being a writer now.